guys, it's Jack here with Rethink Tech, back with a video. So today we will be showing you how to make an MKBHD 3D printed logo. So the first step is to actually create the 3D model, which we used our favorite CAD software, Autodesk Inventor Professional. So we like this software so much because it allows for really advanced modeling in less time than you would think. Also, it's great for assembling multiple models together and has many great features like stress testing, weighing, threaded holes, and much, much more. This is one of the most powerful 3D modeling softwares on the market today. So we started by creating a sketch of MKBHD's logo, then extruding it to make a three-dimensional model. After that, we exported the file as a .stl and imported it to our favorite slicing software, which is Cura. This slicing software works best for our use because it has a simple interface and extremely powerful controls. After all the settings are correct and we check the layers, the file is again exported as a .gcode onto an SD card, which gets put into the 3D printer. We decided to use Hatchbox PLA filament for this project and fed it into the 3D printer. Next, we preheated the nozzle and bed to the correct temperatures and started the print. So the logo is printing at 195 degrees Celsius with a 50% infill and a 0.3 layer height for speed. The printer we're using is an upgraded Sunhoki RepWrap Prusai 3 and is a Bowden feeding system, heated bed, an LCD screen with upgraded axis mounts, motor mounts, end stop mounts, new bearings, and even an E3D V6 nozzle. Once the print was finished, we waited a few minutes for the print and bed to cool down, then we pried on the edges of the logo with a spackling knife until the model popped off. After that, we went outside to spray paint the MKBHD logo red and black. Blue painter's tape was used to cover up the areas we didn't want to paint with that color. So the first coat was red and the second coat was black. We ended up not painting the bottom of the logo, so you can see the original color and line the 3D printer made. After that, we let the logo dry for a while, and that's it. Pretty simple project from CAD to 3D printing to painting. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video about making a custom MKBHD logo. Comment below if you have any ideas for future projects, like the video if you thought it was interesting, and I'll see you guys in the next video.